Hello, I'm Georgie from Jamie's Food Team, and I'm going to show you how to prepare the base for your soup. So we've got here the key ingredients. We've got celery, carrots, onions, and garlic. And this is the perfect base for any soup, not just the soup we're making today. And all of these will add great flavour, sweetness, and they can be used for almost any soup. So what you want to do is, if you just remember two, so you want two sticks of celery, two onions, two carrots, two cloves of garlic, and that will sort you out. So we'll start with the celery. Now, depending on whether or not you're blitzing your soup or you're keeping it as a broth will determine how chunky or fine you want to chop your veg. Always have an empty bowl to hand as well for scraps. It just makes it easier than keep going to the dustbin. So for the celery, you don't need to peel it. Just trim off the ends. And if you want it for a brothy soup, it's quite nice to keep it quite chunky. If you're going to blitz up, it doesn't really matter, to be honest. As long as you get lots of lovely colour and you soften it, you're going to blitz it up anyway. So slice up your celery and push that to one side. And now with your carrots, depends on how, you know, small or fresh your carrots are. You can peel them or just scrub them. I'm just going to peel these. With the onion, cut it in half. I always find it's easier to take the outside off if you cut it in half first. Keep the root intact, because that'll help keep the onion layers together. So when you're cutting it, it won't fall apart. If you chop that off, then you'll be in trouble, because then all the layers will fall apart and you'll make it much harder to chop. So keep that whole, and you can just discard it at the end. And again, cut your onions as fine or as chunky as you like, depending on your type of soup. And then for your garlic, just need a couple of cloves. I just cut off the end just to make it a bit easier to crush, to get the skins off. So put the flat of your knife on top of the garlic, and using the palm of your hand, just push down. Don't push too hard, and this is the easiest way to get the skin off. And again, you can slice or chop your garlic. I like to slice it just because I don't like it to burn or catch too easily, and if you chop it too fine, it can catch and leave a really bitter taste. So just slice it quite fine. There you have it. They're the base ingredients, and all you have to do now is let them get a lovely bit of colour. Okay, so I've got it on a medium-low heat. I'm going to add the garlic first, just for a minute, just because I want to get a little bit of colour onto my garlic. So there we go, it's getting lightly golden now, so that's perfect. So add the rest of your base. Have a good stir. And then literally just sauté the veg for about 10 minutes until it's lovely and soft. And this will give you fantastic flavour for the base of any soup. So there we have it, that's the base of our soup. And as I said before, that will be the base for almost any soup. Those are the key ingredients, and they're lovely and sticky and sweet, and they've been cooked down. And now we've got them to that stage, we can get on with the rest of our soup. Okay, now we've made our base, I'm going to turn this into really delicious tomato and basil soup. So all we need to do is we'll turn this back onto a medium heat. And we're going to put in a tin of really good tin tomatoes. That's one side, and break it up a bit. Just put in a tin of plum tomatoes and broken them up a bit. What I'm going to do now is add three fresh tomatoes. And a nice tip here is actually you could, if you wanted, add the stalks as well, because there's loads of flavour. If you smell that, that's actually where that amazing vine tomato smell comes from. It's not the tomatoes themselves, it's the stalks. And they'll break down, and actually, you know what, put them in as well. Some chicken stock. If you're a vegetarian, you can use veggie stock. It's not a problem. We've got a litre of really lovely organic chicken stock there. And then gently just bring everything to the boil. Season it well, get some freshly ground black pepper. Good sea salt. Bring it to the boil and then simmer it for 15, 20 minutes. I'm gonna put in some fresh basil. So I'm just gonna grab some of the bigger leaves. We can use the little ones for garnishing later. Stir that through. All we need to do now is blitz it till it's smooth. So there we go. That's still got a bit of texture to it, which is lovely. If you want it super smooth, then just carry on blitzing it, that's fine. And you can finish this soup however you like, really. It's really lovely with like a little basil oil. All you have to do is crush up some basil leaves in a pestle and mortar, bash them up with a pinch of salt, really good oil, and drizzle that on top. Or you could even finish it off with a really good homemade pesto, some shavings of parmesan, or a little chopped red chilli for a little kick. That would be great. So there we have it. And just because I absolutely love loads of black pepper, I'm just going to put an extra pinch in the soup like that. A couple of beautiful little basil leaves. And a drizzle. And there you have it. A really fantastic and dead easy tomato and basil soup.